Hey guys, welcome back to our video of creative process. Today we'll be creating blending vector art. We'll be creating 2D design with different techniques. We'll be using pen tool to draw the curve, blend tool to add effects, and the gradient tool to add colors. So let's begin our tutorial. Open a new Illustrator artboard. Select the pen tool, remove the fill color and keep the stroke color black. Now draw out a wavy curve lines, make it smooth and scale it down. In the same way, draw out on the curve with different structure. We'll make this a little bit smaller. Now select both the curves using the selection tool, then select the blend tool. Click on the top left corner of the curve and then click on the bottom left corner when the plus sign shows. This will create a blending object between two curves. To increase the number of steps, double click on the blending tool icon. A panel will open. Here set the spacing to specified steps and then increase the number of steps. Set the numbers and then check out with different values. For this, let's give around 106 steps and click OK. Now place the design aside. Let's draw the curve using the pen tool. This curve will be used to give a specific path to design. You can see the blending between two curves are straight. So to give some dynamic look, we'll use this curve. Adjust the curve as per your desired look. After that, select all and go to Object, Blend, Replace Spline. This will act as a spline for the blends. You can edit the spline by double clicking and adjusting the curve using direct selection tool. Do the changes in the blending path to get better flow. Edit each curve if it is necessary. After everything is set, let's increase the steps to 181. Add a background with a dark blue color. Set our design on the top. Change the stroke thickness to 0.5 points and the stroke color to white. There are some irregularity in blend, so let's edit the spline a little more. Make all the spacing even to give a nice look. After this, select the top curve and add a gradient color to the stroke. Double click on the left gradient slider and select the pink color. Add a little red tone and fade it a little. In the same way, add a color on the right gradient slider with the same color. Then select the bottom curve and apply the gradient with the same color value. To get some interesting effect, let's change the top curve gradient to blue color. Apply it to both the sliders. Now you can see a nice color transition from blue to a faded pink. To add more details, let's decrease the stroke thickness to 0.25 points and increase the steps to around 271. And we got more highlights and effects. To do more adjustments, let's drag the design to Photoshop, scale it down and add a background and contrast adjustment layer. Increase the contrast value around 28 and the brightness value around 22. This will add a glossy highlight effect, and if you switch off the effects, you can see the changes. You can do more color variation using the hue and saturation adjustment layer. Check out with different color shades. And finally, our first design for blending vector art is done. This was the first technique to create such design. Let's use our second technique to create another design. So for the second design, we'll start off with pen tool. Draw a curve with white stroke color. Make a wavy curve in a circular path with the endpoints finishing close to each other. Adjust the curve using direct selection tool. Use the handles to adjust the direction. Create one more wavy curve lines, but this time it's overlapping to each other. After this, adjust each vertices manually. Then select both the curves and apply the blending shapes using this same method. Click the top left points and then the other point. We'll get one step by default. We'll keep it like this. We'll use this middle curve to give different direction and to add unique shapes which was not possible with the previous method. So first of all, select the design and go to Object, Expand. Then right click and ungroup it. This will separate out each curve. You can select the middle curve and do the changes. Adjust the curve to add a different flow to the blend. Adjust the vertices to give different pattern in between. Also make sure there are no sharp corners. Everything should be smooth. You can experiment with different shapes and come up with different designs. After completing the adjustments, select all the three curves and use the blend tool. First click on the top curve left points, then the middle curve left points, and finally the bottom curve right points. Then increase the steps to around 75 and the stroke thickness to 0.25 points. Now let's do adjustment with individual curves. Increase the steps to 182. Add a gradient color to the top stroke. Give blue color to the left gradient slider and the faded pink to the right gradient slider. Then change the rotation to minus 90 degree. This will keep the blue color on the top and the faded pink on the bottom. Now select the middle curve and apply the same gradient color. And then the bottom curve and apply the faded pink to both the slider. After that, double click outside. will reduce the stroke thickness to 0.1 points and adjust the curves. Now, drag and drop to Photoshop, add brightness and contrast adjustment layer and adjust the value to add more highlights and details to design. Finally, our second design is ready. We have used very simple techniques to create out this blending vector art. We can go further and add nice fonts and do the final refinement. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.